Arman Kusaro has asked us how to paint the pelt of a Stormcast Eternal's Vanguard-Hunter. Now to do this, we can actually use one of the colour swatches that appears in the Citadel Paint app, specifically Wood Brown, although we're going to make a slight change to it just because of the texture of the pelt. Now to start out with, we're going to base coat all the pelt using Dryad Bark, and then we're going to start roughly painting in our pattern using Gorthor Brown. After this, we'll shade all over the pelt with Agrax Earthshade and then build on that pattern with Baneblade Brown. Finally, we're going to add some Tyrant Skull to dry brush the pelt to really bring out the texture of the fur. But we need to start out with Dryad Bark, which I'm going to be applying with my medium base brush, and you can see my miniature has been undercoated using Retributor Armour Spray, which is a perfect undercoat if you're doing the Hammers of Sigmar, although this technique will work no matter what storm host you're doing. So once you've got your paint ready and thinned down on your palette, all you've got to do is start blocking in all that fur. And with this colour, I do recommend applying two thin coats, being sure to paint it in amongst all the texture as you apply it. Once you've base coated the pelt, you're then ready to start painting in your pattern using Gorthor Brown. Now for this pelt, what I'm going to do is start applying this in for a kind of zigzag pattern towards the side. So you can see I'm painting an arrow coming in from the side like that, and I'm going to do another one above it and below it, working all the way down like this. Now I'm going to build up the colour to be a little bit stronger, so I recommend applying two thin coats at this stage. Once you're happy with your pattern, you're then ready to start shading it with Agrax Earthshade. Now I'm going to focus this more in the recessed creases of the pelt, such as just around here, but for the more raised parts, I want to keep a thin coat of it just so to make sure I don't darken it down too much. Once the shade is completely dry, we're ready to build on that pattern a bit further with Baneblade Brown. Now thin this down a little bit just so that as I apply it, you can see it starts to run in amongst the fur like this. And I'm following along with the same pattern we did previously, just a little bit further along towards the edges of the pelt. So this way you can see it starts darker in the middle, gradually goes to Gorthor Brown and gets lighter as we get further towards the edges. And once again, I'm going to be applying two thin coats with this colour. And finally, apply a light dry brush of Tyrant Skull to really bring out the texture of the pelt and also to bring those colours together as well. And there we are, the pelt is complete. And of course, you can easily vary the pattern to get as much variety across the unit as you like. But Arman, I really hope that helps you out, and we'll see you all again soon.